If it is or if it ain't, it's gonna come out.
Everybody, it's your girl Miracle Sims, and you are listening to God, Sex, and Love, your daily dose of inspiration and juice. It is March 28th, 2022, and today the topic is You Are a Work of Art. Happy Monday. Happy Monday, everybody. I hope that you all had a wonderful weekend. Mine was just fun. I guess we can get into the nitty-gritty details of what all happened this weekend in the after show. But for the most part, if I just say in general, y'all know that we had the celebration of life for my Uncle Tim on Saturday. And then yesterday, I ended up doing an interview for another podcast and everything like that. But yeah, I guess y'all have to stay tuned, those of you all that are watching me live, to hear more about that. Yeah, so let's get into this chit-chat about you, right, being a work of art. Well, my prayer meditation was kind of centered around this idea today, and actually this was the last thing that the guide said on the Soul Space app. Something along these lines of you are a work of art, and the word art stood out to me. And so that's what I looked up in regards to the verses. Now, the interesting thing is, when I looked up the definition of art, it specifically said something along the lines of, like, something that human creates, X, Y, and Z. Y'all can look up the exact definition yourselves. But I found that to be interesting, because I'm like, okay, well, how you just gonna, you know, leave God out of the scenario? Like, you didn't have to just say what a human creates, you know what I mean? Like, why couldn't it been, or why couldn't it have been, you know, just a creation, X, Y, and Z, and then go from there? Because, I mean, God is the ultimate artist. I mean, he done created everything, you know? So it's like, you know, you can't leave that out, you know? But, so yeah, I found it to be interesting today, just looking at the definition of art. But here are the verses that I felt led to share this morning in regards to this topic. So Isaiah 64:8 says, "But now, O Lord, you are our Father, we are the clay, and you are our potter. We are all the work of your hand." Yeah. You know, not only are we the work of his hands, but, you know, everything is, you know. I think that's what we tend to forget. even the things we create, right? I know we probably don't like to think about that. We probably think, you know, that's pulp or whatever. But, I mean, you know, I guess ultimately when you realize that God created everything, then you're like, oh, okay, so that means he created my thoughts. And that means that he put thoughts in my mind for the things that I create. And so, again, I mean, I think it just puts things into perspective to realize that, I mean, I guess as I was writing these verses down this morning, one of the things that came to me is that it's important for us to understand who we are, right? And I guess even whose we are, because if we don't, I guess, understand that, then I mean, again, we can see all around us the results, right? You know, we don't value life. We don't value ourselves. We don't value each other. And all of that. It was interesting. I did not watch the Oscars. And I know I'm an actor. And I get, you know, look. I took the red pill, went down the rabbit hole, and I told y'all already. But regardless of that, right? I did hear about the altercation. Yeah, between Will Smith and Chris Rock. I mean, you know, hey, you know, at the end of the day, without getting too deep into that particular thing, you know, I just would say I found it interesting. I saw a few responses, and then I tuned in to something to Marcus Rogers' response, and you know, he kind of had a word for, you know, Will Smith and everything like that. And what stood out to me in that message was him referring to, you know, a man who has it all, right? Or seemingly has it all, but you can tell that something is missing or some that perhaps will, you know, could be empty inside and whatnot, which caused such a reaction, right? Or one of the causes of such a reaction. And I guess that resonated with me this morning because I understand that. I understand that feeling of emptiness. I think I've shared with you all before multiple times of like ways that I felt that way in life, you know, where it's like I'm striving, I'm going, I'm doing, but I felt empty, right? I felt like something was missing, you know? And now, again, for me, throughout that time, I drew near to God. You know, throughout that time, it's led me to be where I am by, you know, casting my cares on God, seeking God, talking to God, expressing myself to Him, and receiving something from Him during that time as well, and just now, even now, you know, and so, again, you know, so I can live with peace, joy, and all these things now, contentment and all this, and whatnot. And I feel like I get confirmations almost daily of God working and moving with me, for me, and through me, you know. So yeah, I mean, again, the importance of understanding who we are and whose we are. You know, I also came across a video, I believe it was yesterday, and it was of this lady that had like two closets of all these expensive things, right? And as she showed off, you know, all these, you know, all this material things that she has accumulated over the years and whatnot. She literally said that she had no identity. So yeah, I mean, you know, like the word said, like, what does it profit a man to gain the world but lose his soul? I guess we should ask ourselves that today. And if you're in that place, right, if you feel like as if you're in this place, then, and you somehow came across this, right, and you're listening to the sound of my voice today, then I'm here to remind you, friend, that you are beautifully and wonderfully made. You were created by God for a purpose. And at the end of the day, yes, you are a work of art. And let's see what else the Bible has to say about that. So, Ecclesiastes 3 and 11 says, He has made everything beautiful in its time. Also, he has put eternity into man's heart, yet so that he cannot find out what God has done from the beginning to the end. All right, so look, God's keeping some secrets from us, you know what I'm saying? That might be the pulp of that verse today. You know, it started out real beautiful, to be honest. Like, you know, it says here that he has made everything beautiful in its time. That means, you know, every single thing. I told y'all before numerous times that debacles, the crazy things that happened in my life, you know, has led to some of the most beautiful relationships and the beautiful things that I have in my life currently, you know. And although I didn't understand it at the time when I was going through what we call like the miry, you know, bog, you know, to be on the other side and see, the green pastures, like me and all my gardening references. But anywho, I've seen what God has done in my life personally, when it comes to this. And so I can see how, God has made everything beautiful in his time in my life, right? But again, there's just certain things. If I touch on this last part of that verse there, certain things is above our pay grade, right? Certain things, I guess you won't be able to access until you're spiritually ready, right? Or maybe there's some things we just probably won't be privy to until God feels that we are, not just say worthy of being privy to, but like, I don't know, ready, any other word that you can put there to let us know that, in that in due season, in due time, right? So yeah, I mean, again, if you want wisdom, right? If you want to know a little bit more about why God do and what God is doing and all of that, the least you can do is ask. The least you can do is ask. Now, that doesn't mean God's gonna let you know everything, but he might bring some things to your attention or to your to you. Just put it like that. So, I don't know if that was a bitter ass sweet little verse right there, but I mean, that's that. Ephesians 2 and 10, it says, "For we are his workmanship, created in Jesus." Excuse me, I'm gonna read it right. It says, let me say it again. Ephesians 2 and 10, it says, "For we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus for good works, which God prepared beforehand that we should walk in them." It says in the Bible that God knew us in the womb, obviously he knew us even before then, right? And that, I mean, I would say that each and every one of us, according to this, are his workmanship created in Christ Jesus for good works. Now, again, it's up to us to do the good works, right? To choose to do the good works and use our free will for the good that he has created us for. However, that doesn't take away from the calling that God has on us in our lives. So, again, if nothing else, friends, just remember that at the end of the day, you are a work of art created for a purpose, for good works, for good works. And I hope that you are encouraged and inspired to walk in it. If you guys need a little bit more information about, I guess what God has created you for or anything like that, check out the Go Deeper section. I feel like these verses are beautiful explanations or maybe even a peek into, God's plan for us in general, because obviously we all are unique and there's different things and gifts and whatnot that God gives each and every one of us. But in general, I think, these verses that are in the Go Deeper section could give a little bit more insight into that. So I hope that you all peruse them and let them marinate on your hearts, souls, and minds today. But yeah, that's the juice. That's the juice this morning. The Bible verse of today is Proverbs 3, 5 through 6. It says, "Trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not unto all thine own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy paths." Friends, I hope you all enjoyed this juice this morning. Thank you so much for listening to God, Sex, and Love, your daily dose of inspiration and juice. I pray you guys can go forth and have a wonderful day, and I look forward to talking to you all tomorrow, if the Lord's will. Bye-bye.
Hello, charmers. Visit ttcboutique.com for the latest in fashion and accessories. Twice the charm, the source of women clothing.